Dr. Nardi here, and in this video I want to talk about the brain, but more specifically I want to talk about the basic building blocks of the brain, also known as neurons. Now neurons come in different flavors, but overall we can look at neurons as specialized cells that convey sensory information to the brain. They carry out operations involved with thought, feeling, and action, and they transmit commands throughout the body. And if you notice here, we have about 17 billion neurons in our higher order brain areas, which we'll talk about in a little more detail. The cerebellum has about 69 billion neurons. The spinal cord contains about 1 billion neurons. Some neuroscientists estimate that there are more neurons in your brain than stars in our galaxy. So let's talk about the basic structure of a neuron. And I think the best place to start is the cell body, or soma, as it's also referred to. And the cell body is filled with a liquid called cytoplasm and contains a number of organelles. The largest of these organelles is the nucleus, which contains the cell's chromosomes. Other organelles are responsible for converting nutrients into fuel for the cell. Some construct proteins and lipids, and some organelles remove waste materials. In this illustration, we can see the typical depiction of this actually is a multipolar motor neuron. And we'll talk about what multipolar means in a little bit here, but this is a quote unquote typical neuron. So we're gonna use this to kind of go over the basic components. Now, if you take a look, you can see these dendrites. And these dendrites are extensions that branch out from the cell body, and their whole mission is to receive information from other neurons. And here's the thing, this branching structure that you see allows them to collect information from many, many different neurons. And if we follow this, we can see the axon. Now the axon extends like a tail from the actual cell body here, and it carries information to other locations, and sometimes this axon can be very long, so it carries information across great distances. You'll also notice as part of this axon, there's a myelin sheath that wraps around the axon, and this basically, think of it as insulation. Like insulation on a copper wire that helps the conduction of neural transmissions. So it helps facilitate the electrical impulse down the axon. And if you follow the axon all the way down, you'll see these branches at the end of the axon, and you'll see these swelling, and these are the axon terminals. Now these axon terminals contain neurotransmitters, which is, by the way, how neurons communicate with one another. No neurons ever directly connect. They release these neurotransmitters across the synapse, or across the spaces between neurons, in order to communicate. Just as a point of reference, this neuron is giant, so we can see it, but neurons are so small that they usually can only be seen with the aid of a microscope. The cell body, which is the largest part of the neuron, ranges from 0.005 to 0.1 millimeters. And by the way, in case you're unfamiliar with the metric system, it's about the thickness of a dime. Now, we have different types of neurons, besides your motor neuron, which is involved in movement. We also have a sensory neuron, which basically collects information from the body and the outside world and brings it into the brain and the spinal cord. Now, motor and sensory neurons have some of the same components, but they are configured differently. For example, a motor neuron's axon and the dendrites extend in several directions from the cell body, which is, by the way, we call it multipolar. Sensory neurons can either be unipolar or bipolar. And if a neuron is unipolar, it's because it has a single short stalk from the cell body that divides it into two branches. It has dendrites on one side and an axon and the terminals on the other. And a bipolar neuron have an axon on one side of the cell body and dendrites process on the other. And the third type of neuron that I want to mention is not a sensory neuron nor a motor neuron, but we call this an interneuron. And actually, you can see it right here in figure C. An interneuron connects one neuron to the same part of the brain or spinal cord. If you notice, though, that this neuron is multipolar, but the axon appears to be missing. And that's the case for some interneurons. The reason for this is because interneurons make connections over very short distances, so they do not need long axons that characterize the motor and sensory neurons. Down here in figure C, you'll see an interneuron. And if you notice, it doesn't appear to have an axon. That's because interneurons communicate on such short distances that a long axon is not needed in comparison to sensory neurons and motor neurons. So just to recap, motor neurons conduct messages from the brain to the muscles and organs. They're multipolar. They're found throughout the nervous system. And how we would describe them is they have an axon, dendrites extend in several directions from the cell body. Sensory neurons carry information from the body and the world to the brain and spinal cord. They're unipolar outside the brain, bipolar outside the brain and spinal cord, and they have a little bit of distinctions. So when they're unipolar, they usually have a single short stalk from the cell body, which divides them into two branches. When they're bipolar, the axon and the dendritic processes are on the opposite sides of the cell body. Finally, we have interneurons. Interneurons conduct information between neurons in the same area. They are multipolar, and you can find these in the brain and spinal cord, and they have a very short axon that communicates locally, meaning they communicate with nearby neurons.